So I play a character called Shane, who is Nick's best friend, who's played by Joe Thomas. And Joe's character's just been dumped by his girlfriend at graduation. And Shane thinks it would be a great idea if we just went to a music festival for a few days. And it's just like everything that could go wrong at a music festival for these guys go wrong. And it's just a good laugh, and people have fun. It's a good laugh, it's fun, it's really warm as well. And I think if you want to have a good laugh, if you want to, like, just smile for 90 minutes, this is the film to watch.
Of course, part of the film was actually made at a real festival. Can you talk about those experiences? I'd imagine some memorable moments.
Yeah, so we filmed at Bestival, and we also filmed at Leeds Festival. And that was wild, to say the least. I can't say any more than that. I feel like the best moments were at Leeds Festival, where Joe played Simon Says on the main stage in front of 50, maybe 60,000 people. That was incredible.
What do you think it is about the environment of a festival that captures our imagination so much?
It's just that everyone is just allowed to have fun. It's complete freedom. Doesn't matter what colour you are, what size you are. It doesn't matter, gender, whatever. It's just thousands of people on the field having fun, and that's what it's all about. Love, man, love.
You and Joe are playing best friends in this film. What's Joe like? Because obviously we have a sense of who he is from the characters he's played. How close is the reality?
I feel like Joe and Nick are like the same, different versions of the same person, you know what I mean? I feel like Nick is a different version of Joe, and I feel like Shane is a different version of me. So it was really easy for me and Joe to click and to create that chemistry on screen and that. So I think, yeah, I think they're similar and different.
Nick is a character who's very much having a bad time at a festival. Yeah. I'm curious, did you feel sorry for Joe, or is it actually quite fun seeing him tortured the way he is in this film?
Oh, I thought it was hilarious. I was laughing, not like so he could see, but in secret, so he wouldn't feel bad.
What was cracking you up the most? What was the worst thing that Ian was doing to Joe?
Oh, you just have to watch the film, and you'll see it all. And there'll probably be like a DVD with all like the deleted scenes in there, and you see more. So yeah, it's all good.
Obviously, people who've seen the trailer will have seen some of your dance moves. Yeah. I'm curious, how natural was that, and how much prep went into that routine?
Oh, come on, man! It was a bit of both. It was a bit of both. You'll see. Watch the film, man. It was an absolute dream to work with Ian. I've always wanted to be a part. Like growing up watching The In Between Us, I've always admired his work. I've always wanted to work with him. So to have this opportunity, it's just blessings. And I'm super grateful. And this is amazing. Like, I've never done anything like this before. And I am so, so excited for what's about to come.
Curious, I mean, there's going to be obvious comparisons with The In Between Us. Yeah. How do you think it does sort of match up? Are there differences?
It's definitely got the same essence, the same comedic essence. I mean, whether you enjoy The In Between Us, whether you're not, you're going to enjoy it. I guarantee you're going to enjoy it. It's a good laugh. And you're definitely going to smile for 90 minutes. It's so funny, and everyone can relate to it. Whether you go to festivals or not, it's a good laugh.